So you probably couldn't open it then. This is how you get over there. It's still building, isn't it?
Treasure car. Bring them to me, and I'll reward you handsomely. Scales have returned, and I owe it all to you. Finally, the time has come for him to pay the price for his crime. But scales are priceless. It's almost as if I'm priceless too. You there, you've done a remarkable job, though I feel that I can rely on you, or rather, my secret.
Sure.
Oh, wonderful. Truly remarkable. Now, the secret I mentioned. I'd like you to present this bait to the great car. Not let anyone see if you can help it. Be as stealthy as possible. Present it to and remember, do that. And oh, oh. Hello again. Quietly.
Thank you.
yeah, shit, the seed.
All this time, nobility this, and eternity that. Pretty lies to fool him. Give him back! Father, my father, give him back!
Yeah, what's up, Steven? How you been, dude? at her fucking bar. Typical shit. Can you've got no posture. I'm all good doing them all, but obviously, you have your shit days, you do have your shit days. I've got a feeling that's the boss. How the fuck did I not see that? So how the hell do you get to the other side? Obviously because of the PlayStation exclusive. Oh yeah. Did you actually get over there then from the... So you do. You son of a bitch. Wait, did I fall back? Did I fall down? I didn't, did I? No, I didn't. Because I've not been here yet. I've not been on this side. Oh, there's even a shrine there as well. I've got the feeling I'm near the end of the game because when I came here, I got the achievement to locate, well, visit every place on the game. So I'm presuming I'm near the end. Right, this will be the big fish. Seems like you've flown through the game, feels like it. Of course, mate. Of course, mate. Of course, of course. Right, so maybe, because I talked to a dude. Well, not really a dude, it's like a plant, like a pot. Near, pretty much near the beginning, but it was here. And they told me to feed it that. Because I bumped into the fish. But when I put, because I put, obviously played earlier. I was running around. Oh shit. That other dude here, so maybe if I could talk to him. Because he said that part, he said that the dude that's here is like a disgrace to the clan. He wanted to kill the fish. But obviously now he's gone, he's died or something. So obviously if I go to this dude, it might tell me. But yeah, I'm running along thinking, shit, how do I get to the... obviously, how did I get to the tower? Make sure you had to go through the water. And then when you go through the water, the big fish appears. And then obviously, it's pretty much just like the snake. You've got to get past it in a way without it seeing you. Oh, it's one of these fishes. Can do a 13-hit combo now, Jago. Sweet, figured out how to extend it. Sweet.
Oh,
Even he's dead. Oh yeah, as well, I think I can change this place again, because I got a...
When did I get it?
I got another bell. Yeah, Father's Bell Charm. Offering at that, at the temple, with that statue. One thing that I find strange though, is that this is glowing yellow. Wait, it feels like I'm forgetting something. I versed one of them fucking headless dudes, and he was in there. He was in the where the big water place is. I did pick up the flower, didn't I? Yeah, of course I did, because that's how I got to that place. By by giving it to all the kid, and then he teleports you there. Well, no exactly teleport. Oh, okay. How many achievements do you have you got left? Yeah. Well, I've still got quite a few, but I just wanted to get all them. Upgrade all my arm. Upgrade my life. Upgrade my flasks. I have got another seed. And then all these are secret. One of them's obviously got to be complete the game. And maybe, because I am coming up again, I can definitely tell that I'm coming up against a boss in that new place. So maybe one of them's the achievement as well. I did pick it up, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Yeah. Mate. the fuck? No way, it was saying that I went there for the first time. Right, anyway. Where is... Pardon me. Yeah, because I went back up, I went through the tower again. And obviously, a good job I did, because it actually spawned more bosses. It spawned more mini-bosses. So I got more, as you can see by my health, I got more beads. And I've just got a seed. I ordered that 50 cent game yesterday. I missed it. Yeah. Also, this picture, I went back to the tower and there were a woman there saying that there's a demon supposedly around here. So maybe it's like a boss, mini, like a secret boss. Oh yeah, also as well, game. Where the hell's Emma? Oh yeah, shit, she came back here, didn't she? This is a typical last gen game for me. Yeah, game near me, it's getting closed down. Mate, I don't give a shit. At least it's open for when I go and get Dragon Ball Z, so I can get my card, I'm not fucking bothered. Oh yeah, as well, fucking hell. This dude.
Hey there, friend, still have some business.
That was the dude at the side of the castle. And he had a seed.
Until next time, friend.
Yep. Game name, he's getting shut down. I don't really buy from there anyway. Because its prices are fucking stupid. Since it's different from the main site.
Master Owl, there's no telling what it might reveal to you. So please, take care.
There's that then. Fully upgraded the healing ground.
Lord Kuro is bound to be the divine heir of the dragon's heritage for eternity. My wish is that he could be freed of this burden and pursue a normal life. That is all I pray for. Goodbye, Matt.
So, I need... Yep. Prices are fucking stupid. I'm surprised they've lasted this long, to be fair. Because the prices were absolutely stupid. So maybe they might do like a closing sale, mate. Finally put prices down on fucking games. So it is different. Put me here. Enemies are still the same level. Yeah, last time. Last thing that I brought in there were obviously Borderlands, so I can get the mask. I'm pretty sure they bring out a Dragon Ball Super card game for the Switch, I'm buying it. So is this bit different now? Because I spawned here. Oh shit, got some ninjas.
Oh, you're supposed to be dead. Yeah, you still live. It doesn't matter.
Hey! I wanna get rid of your dog. Can you fuck off for a sec? Can you just fuck off for a sec, please? I wanna get rid of your dog. But to be fair, it wouldn't be bad to keep him because then you could just get me off the fire and then die. No, Yu-Gi-Oh's totally fucking. I don't count. Yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh's nothing like it. Yu-Gi-Oh's pretty much the game. If you've got that card, if you've got that deck, you're gonna win. If you come up against someone that hasn't really got a decent deck, you're going to win. Because you've obviously got the cards. You've not got cards to control. Gotta be on him, so they don't call his dogs. That's his gimmick. The one thing that I don't get about this fucking game though, you can upgrade your health, but yeah, when you get towards enemies, they do more damage. Well, it's typical soul shit. Upgrade your health, but then you go up against enemies that can kill you in 2 hits. Wait, can't I use... Just realised. I can use this. Cancel my swing. Why did it cancel my swing? Shut up. That's it. Attack him. Like you're supposed to. Don't attack me. Fine. Good old. How did you want that? Fucking cheating bitch. Just keep swinging, man. I'm just gonna land you in time. Stage one. Fire. Give me my bead. Bitch. Great. And I got the fucking axe on me. I'm pretty sure that's like the first ever time I've actually versed a dude. No, it's not. Because I versed one in that forest. But you could obviously insta kill him. You could just fucking stab the bastard and fuck off. Yeah, because what the one thing that I really like about Dragon Ball Super Card Game is that with the new cards that are coming out, it also helps our old leaders as well. All these new cards, obviously, like I just said, there's new cards that can make old leaders good because what they do. It's like with that Gohan leader. Uh, when he attacks, when from the old one, from obviously the one from set two, the effects that he has, that when he attacks, if you've got a Son Goku in the drop, he gains 5k. And then when you're four or less, life's four or less, that hit me, you draw two. And then on his back, while on the awakened side, if I remember, when he swings, draw a card, and then activate battle? I think it's activate battle or activate main. Put all your cards in your hand. No, put all the cards in your drop here out of the game, then he gains triple strike. But at the end of the turn, you lose the game. Obviously, yeah, that sounds fucking good, because he gains triple strike. It's like a last, like a fucking final hit, but it can be negated. So you could do all that shit. Right, any negates, negate, I win. And obviously with this one, it's totally fucking different. Choose two cards in your life and add it to your fucking hand. You having a laugh? Leaders that can crit themselves, but you can add the cards to your hand, is classed as a good thing, because if you can get cards, like there's like a, I'm pretty sure nearly every single color's got it, I think, but I don't think black's got it yet. When you swing with the card, it's a one drop, it's got 5k, but when you swing, you can take a card from your life, add it to your hand, and then it gains 10k in crit. And obviously crit, it makes it so your opponent has to place the card in the drop here and not in the hand. But it's like at the same time, you see, well, they call it self-awakening, because it's like with the deck that I built, that I like, by my turn two, I could awaken by turn two. So obviously then, when they swing with their leader, they have to potentially drop two cards. If they want to swing at my leader, they have to drop two cards. Because 9 out of 10 leaders, on the non-awakened side, the 10k, and then on the awakened side, the 15. So obviously they've got, when they swing, they have to drop two cards to beat me. So it's pretty much a waste. So that's the reason why they do it. And I didn't realize I've got 558 of them sold. But yeah, that go on card, it seems like it's going to get some play. Now we just need to see what it does on its awakened side. Yeah, because what I'm thinking about doing as well, when this new set comes out, well, I will be able to get my hands on the box early before it even releases, because I'm going to a pre-release event, and then whenever, obviously when people host them, you can actually buy the box, like buy an actual box of the set at the event. So pretty much what I'm going to do, obviously I'm going to buy one, and then what I'm thinking about doing, because I always open boxes at my brother's, but obviously I always go over to my brother's room, but obviously I open it to him. I'm thinking about, when I obviously get the box, come home, we open it, and I'm going to stream it. The only thing I need is a webcam, because he's got a laptop, download extra. Just bring my webcam, slap it in, done. Well, and plus we do need a mic, because obviously if I pull a fucking secret ray, you just see fucking screen shaking, me fucking jumping about. But you just can't hear shit. What's down here? I've got a feeling I'm going to die. I can remember coming down here above, but it just seems like... nothing. Oh no. So yeah, I was thinking about doing that. Wait, was I getting hit there and it wasn't hurting me? Yeah, that's what I'm gonna start and do. Whenever I get boxes, I'm gonna ultra mega rare. Ultra super mega rare. Yeah, they're called secrets. They're called SCRs, secret rares. Every set gets a secret rare. Well, you used to get one, but now you get fucking three. Willing with Goku. Mate. Imagine if... Imagine how fucking sick the front cover in Neo. How fucking sick that would look in the card. Like a proper fucking good looking card. Fuck it up. That look fucking sick. Like I said, when I shown you the cards, the fucking camera, like I said, that camera don't do it justice. The only way it would do it justice if I buy like one of them stupid fucking high super def fucking 4K bollocks, but I'm obviously not gonna do that. I fucking struggle with fucking streaming fucking 720p. Mind you, fucking 4K. Fucking hell. Dynasty Warriors cards are mate. I think there is Dynasty Warriors cards, but obviously not Dynasty Warriors. It's obviously thingy. I'm pretty sure that it's called Three Kingdoms. I think. I know that there's a card-based game around it. Man, I'm not tripping. There was a person right there and it just disappeared. Yeah, there was. What was up here? Well, I think that was just a way just to get around this bit, I think. Yeah, it was. Because you could come from the wall and then you come up here and then it pretty much skips that entire bit. Because my pull rates, mate, for some of these fucking boxes that I've been buying, fuck it. Been pulling some fucking secrets since the, like, fucking, like, what? It's like, I think it says... Out of four boxes, you'll get one. I think it's something like that, but with these secret rares, since it's three, it's like more of a high chance that you're going to pull one because there's three. Because I'm presuming this set's going to do the same as the previous one. Because they used to, when you buy a box, 24 packs, there's 12 cards in each. And every time you open a pack, you're guaranteed to get a rare or better. Mainly rare. But... Do you play the cards? Fuck no. Secret rares, yeah. I mean, secret rares, yeah. If they're secret rares, I don't play them. Even if they are fucking... I don't give a shit. I ain't playing none of them. People that do, they're fucking stupid. Like the people that play the fucking Goku card. The Ultra Instinct one, the best secret rare. It's worth nearly 300 fucking quid. Oh, just slap in the sleeve and play it. Yeah. Playing a 300 quid card, and then it just takes that one person to be a dick and just like, right, I'm just gonna squish it. Yeah, the card's fucked. I even think to pretend as a madman that there's a fucking. There's some. It's like even the deck that I've built, the one that I like, there's a card in there. Came out with the latest set, that came out set 8. It's the Super Saiyan 4 Goku. Super Saiyan 4 Goku with a heart-filled plea, I think that's what it's called. It's a super rare, it's worth about nearly 30 quid, 35 quid, and I've got three of the bastards in the deck. I've got three! You still keep the cards though. Yeah, but you're playing it. You're putting your fingers on it. Yeah, I know it's in the sleeve, but still, you're playing it, you're touching it. Nah, mate, I fucking can't do that. Anyway, I do that is I forget, like, every... But it's like every single card in my deck's gonna have that packet on. There's like a fucking proper plastic casing that you can get. If all my cards have got on, I'm not fucking bothered and I'll play it because it's in like a proper protection thing. Don't give a shit. It's like the Vegeta card that I've shown you. The secret rare that I've got from the latest set. I've got it twice. It's a good fucking card. Stupidly fucking good. Well, it, obviously it is because it's worth nearly 250 quid. It's a good fucking card. Imagine if you lost them. Well, to be fair, if you can collect them once, you can collect them again. Would be a nightmare, yeah. Plus, with these people in Dragon Ball Super Card Game community, mate, they don't, some of them, mate, they don't give a flying fuck what card it is. Like I've told you before, it's like, if I'm trading something, if I'm trying to find a card, if it's in my deck, if I'm doing it, like, purpose for a deck, then I don't mind, because I'm obviously using it in a deck. But if I'm getting the card just to collect it, because the card obviously to me looks fucking sick, it has to be prestige, like pristine, sorry. You can't have no fuck all on it. Ties and I'm just damaging. It's like with these people with the Dragon Ball Super Card Game community, for some reason, whenever they put cards like in the trades, they don't put them in sleeves. You'll keep them out as normal, but because they've kept them in a secure place like for so fucking long with no sleeves, because of the altitude being hot and cold, combo. But without a doubt, mate, that Goku card, it's an uncommon. That card is gonna look badass. I'm not really fighting these on the top of because it should have been. So that's atrocious. But yeah, the cards, without a doubt, mate, they look fucking awesome. But yeah, I'm definitely.